Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to remove the not null constraint from an existing column of a table in MySQL. So let's get started. So first let me just go and create a database and a table. So this is my table, the name is my table, and here I'm having two columns. One is ID and another one is mark, and our mark column is going to have the not null constraint. So let me just now create this. Yeah, so I'm getting a green mark, so my table has been now created. So if I just now try to insert a null value, so here you can see I'm trying to insert 5 and null. So if I do that, I'll be obviously getting an error because it says mark cannot be null because we are just having a not null constraint. So if I just go to my table description, and if I just go here, yeah, so here you can see I'm having, because I have just applied the not null constraint. So now I will be showing you how to remove the constraint from our mark column. So for that, we will be using the alter and the modify keywords. So just scroll down. It's going to be alter table, your table name. My table name is my table over here. My table, modify column. Then you need to specify the column name that you want to remove the not null constraint. So in my case, it is mark. So I will go with mark. And then you need to specify the data type of your column. So in my case, it is int. That's it. So it's alter table, table name, modify column, mark and int. Be careful with the cases as well as the spelling. So if I just now run it. Yeah, I'm getting a green mark now. And if I just go to my table description. So here you can see we are having null yes for both the columns. Just before a moment, before running this command, we were having null no for mark. So which means that our constraint has been now removed. Let's also confirm it more by inserting a null value. So let me just now run this. Yeah, I'm running it twice. And if I just now select asterisk for my table. So here you can see I'm having null value in the mark column. So which means that our constraint has now successfully removed. And this is how you do it. I hope you would have found this video useful. I've also run many other tutorials in MySQL, C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB. So do check other videos off my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.